गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल एट योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल विज्ञान विहान दैट वॉज फॉर्मरली सीमा ज्ञान नॉलेज शेयर। वी अपलोड नॉलेज शेयरिंग वीडियोज ऑन दिस चैनल फॉर अवर व्यूअर्स। दिस इज अवर सीरीज फॉर UGC CSIR NET पार्ट ए विच इज जनरल एप्टीट्यूड। इन दिस एपिसोड वी विल सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ UGC CSIR NET जून 2015 दैट वॉज द पेपर ऑफ मैथमेटिकल साइंसेज लाइफ साइंसेज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 11 to 20। लेट्स स्टार्ट द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स। हियर द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस एपिसोड 11th प्रॉब्लम। हाउ मेनी नॉन नेगेटिव इंटीजर्स लेस देन 10,000 आर देयर सच दैट द सम ऑफ द डिजिट्स ऑफ द नंबर इज डिवाइजेबल बाय 3। ऑप्शन 1 1,112, ऑप्शन 2 2,213, ऑप्शन 3 2,223, ऑप्शन 4 3,334। प्रॉब्लम नंबर 11। अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस प्रॉब्लम हाउ मेनी नॉन नेगेटिव इंटीजर्स स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 0, 1, 2, 3 लाइक दिस। लेस देन 10,000 आर सच दैट लेस देन 10,000 दैट मीन द नंबर्स आर हियर लाइक 9998 4 times 9 and the 10,000. So, we would have to calculate the number of the numbers which are between these limits. Sum of the digits of the numbers is divisible by 3. First, we would have to conceptualize what is question asking. We know if any number is divisible by 3, then the total of its digits also divisible by 3 such that 69, 54 like this. If you add the digits of any such number which is divisible by 3, the total of their digits like here 15, 9. So we would have to select only those numbers which are divisible by 3 between 0 and 10,000. So let's start. The number which is divisible by 3 is maximum 9,999. So every third number is divisible by 3. First keep aside 0, then count the numbers. The first number is 3, second number is 6, like this. The order number of 9,999 can be calculated by 9,999 divided by 3, that is 3,333. One remaining positive number which is also divisible by any number is 0 here. So add 1. Here would be our answer, which is 3,334. The correct answer of this problem would be option number 4, 3,334. 12th problem. Of the three persons A, B and C, one always lies while the others always speak the truth. C asked A, "Do you always speak the truth? Yes or no?" He said something that C could not hear. So C asked B, "Why did A say?" B replied, "A said no." So who is the liar? Option 1 A, option 2 B, option 3 C, option 4 cannot be determined, which is quite confusing. In this problem, there are three persons A, B and C. According to the given problem, one of the persons always lies, the two others always speaks truth. In this problem, first C asked A, "Do you always speak truth? Yes or no?" Then A answered something which C could not listen. Then C asked B, "What did A say?" B replied to C. A said no. In this question, we would have to recognize the liar person. There are given four options A, B, C, and fourth cannot be recognized. So, let's start the solution. There is first situation when in first sentence C asked A. So, C is the first person. Then he asked A. He asked A something. Do you always speak truth? If C is asking, he is the reference person, then assume C as the man of truth. When C asked A, then let A replied to C, yes. In that condition, A is a liar person. But if A is a liar person, then you cannot believe on his answer. If he is liar person, he may give you answer no. There is quite doubtful situation. So let's start from the lower part. B replied to C that A said no. A said no. B replied to C no. Let B is the liar person. If B is liar person, then the answer of A must be yes. In that condition, the answer of the question, do you always speak truth? That means A is a man who speaks truth. C is man who speaks truth. But B is the liar who answered wrongly, given a wrong interpretation of answer of A. So, perfectly, B must be the liar person. So, our answer would be option number 2, B. Then again, we can take another situation. If B is a man of truth, then his answer is correct, no. In that situation, B is the man of truth, then he is giving the correct interpretation of answer of A, then the answer of A must be same, that is no. If B is man of truth, A is saying no, then A must be a liar person. And if A is a liar person, you cannot believe his answer no. So, the perfect situation for our answer must be B is the liar person. Correct answer is option 2. Problem number 13. Two ants initially at diametrically opposite points A and B on a circular ring of radius capital R starting crawling towards each other. The speed of one at capital A is half of the one at capital B. The point at which they meet is at a straight line distance from option 1, R from A, option 2, 3R by 2 from A, option 3, R from B, option 4, 3R by 2 from B. Friends, here is our next problem, problem number 13. In the given problem, the points A and B are diametrically opposite with each other on a circle which has its radius capital R. Two ants starts from point A and point B. The ant which start from point A has half of the velocity of the velocity of B. In that condition, we assumed if the speed of ant B is V, then speed of ant A would be V by 2. They meet at some point on the semicircular circumference, on the arc of the semicircle, the point may be P, then the straight line distance of the point. First we make a diagram where if the center is O, then join with point P, this is point O, the ratio of the speed of A and B is here, V1 by V2, 1 by 2, then the ratio of the distance covered would be same, 1 raised to 2. The distance covered is the length of the arc. The radius is everywhere same for a circle. Then the angle theta is arc upon radius. Radius is same. The ratio of the angle covered by that arc, the ratio of the angle would be in the ratio of the length of the arc. So theta 1 ratio theta 2 would be 1 by 2. The total angle is here 180. Then divide it into 1 raised to 2. You would get 60 degree and 120 degree. Then the situation would be like this, 60 degree and 120 degree. Now the main hurdle to get the answer is the straight line distance from A and B. So join the point P with A. This is angle 60 degree. Both the sides of this triangle are equal. So these angles would be same. In that condition, the total angle x plus 60 is 180 for a triangle. So x must be 60 degree. So the triangle AOP is an equilateral triangle. Then AP must be equal to the radius of the circle. So the distance from A of point P must be R. The correct answer of this problem is option 1, R from A. Problem number 14. There is a given graph. Based on the graph, which of the following statements is not true? Option 1, number of gold medals increased whenever total number of medals increased. Option 2, percentage increase in gold medals in 2010 over 2006 is more than the corresponding increase in total medals. Option 3, every time non-gold medals together account for more than 50% of the total medals. Option 4, percentage increase in gold medals in 2010 over 2006 is more than the corresponding increase in 2002 over 1998. It is quite lengthy to read. This problem is based on a graph which is given. In this graph, the dotted line is showing the gold medals number according to the years, and the continuous line is showing the curve of total number of medals corresponding to the given years. Based on the graph, the question is asking to select a statement which is not true. So first we see there are numbers. The numbers of medals are shown with the graph points. So let's start the solution and reading the options from the last option, because such long questions waste your long time, and the answer may be the fourth option. According to the fourth option, the percentage increase in gold medal in 2010 over 2006. So first we would have to calculate the percentage increase in gold in 2010 over 2006. In 2010, this is 38, and in 2006, it is 18. So the change in the number is here 38 minus 18 divided by the initial number in 2006. It is 18. Hence, the percentage increase would be 20 divided by 18 in percentage. It is something more than 100%. It is 111 in percent. Then, to compare it with corresponding increase in 2002 over 1998. Here it is. Initial number is 7. The final number is 22. In that condition, the second condition, the increase is 22 minus 7, that is 15. Divide by the initial number. Initial number is 7 multiply with 100. So the percentage increase would be more than 200%. So this increment is lesser than the increase in the second condition. But here in option 4, it is saying percentage increase in gold medal in 2010 over 2006 is more than the corresponding increase in 2002 over 2098. So this is the statement which is not true. If I start this solution from the option 1, then it would waste my long time, and the correct answer is hidden here at the bottom. The fourth option is the correct answer of this problem. Problem number 15. A pyramid shaped toy is made by tightly placing cubic blocks of 1 by 1 by 1 centimeter cube. The base of the toy is a square 4 by 4 centimeter square. The width of each step is 0.5 centimeter. How many blocks are required to make the toy? There are 4 options. Option 1, 30. Option 2, 34. Option 3, 36. Option 4, 40. Friends, the last problem of this episode, problem number 15, is here. In this problem, we will have to make a pyramid shaped toy which consists of base of 4 by 4 centimeter square with cubes of 1 by 1 by 1 centimeter cube blocks. The base of the pyramid is 4 by 4 centimeter. Then the number of blocks which are required to make this base is 4 by 4, that is 16. Each step is 0.5 centimeter width. Then in second step, what we will do? The first step is here 4 centimeter from one side. The second step will be like this. The step's width is 0.5 centimeter this side and 0.5 centimeter on the other side. So this step has its width 3 centimeter. So for 3 centimeter width steps, we will have to make the second step of 3 by 3 centimeter square. In that condition, we will need the number of blocks required to make the second step is 3 by 3, that is 9. So for first step, which is base 4 by 4, that is number of blocks 16. The second step is 3 by 3, that is number of blocks 9. In same situation, in third step, there are required blocks 2 by 2, that will be 4. And the last and fourth stage, there would be only single block of 1 by 1 centimeter square base area. The number of blocks would be required on the fourth stage 1. The total number of blocks which are required to make this toy would be total of all the blocks. Then 16 plus 9, that is 25 plus 4, 29 plus 1, that is 30. So the answer of this problem would be option 1, 30. Keep practicing. Always attempt easier problems. In MCQ exam of UGC CSIR NET, we will have to attempt only 15 problems out of 20 problems in part A. Keep practicing. If you have any doubts, please comment in the comment box. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends. Please subscribe this channel and tap on the bell icon so that you can get notification. Thank you.